think it's a full minute.
We're going to watch Jess drink her Starbucks.
That's fine, because this episode is also not sponsored by Starbucks, and it should be. Starbucks, where are you? Give me free coffee.
I don't know.
Come on, Starbucks.
I don't know. I watch.
Who's the owner of Starbucks? Who can I yell at?
I don't know, but they're... One of their things is being unionized, and they weren't too happy about it. And one of their stores or whatever.
Yeah, I had no idea, because I'm just in it for the coffee.
I don't know where the hell it is.
I'm just in it for the coffee.
I hate to say it, but Pat Sloan is a Starbucks fan, and she gets gift cards from Starbucks from her.
Well, that's rude, Starbucks. I know you can hear me. There was a video or this thing I saw on Facebook, this post where this girl said, I keep walking by my my boyfriend's phone and talking about engagement rings because it picks up, you know, so it picks up on things. So maybe if I keep saying Starbucks, they'll hear it and they'll sponsor me. Starbucks, send me gift cards. It's rude.
Good morning, Sandy. Good morning, Charlie. Good morning, Sue.
That's all
morning,
I have
Nancy.
To say. Charlie, I don't know if you know this, but you were very missed this weekend.
Yeah.
And very talked about this weekend. Everyone asking, where's Charlie?
Charlie?
My husband said,
where's Charlie?
Where's the guy? He calls you the guy because names are not his thing. I said, he's not here this week. I'm sorry, but he's been wondering. Everybody's been wondering. So Marlene's got an important phone call to take. She left us. Today, we are going to talk about color theory, and I'm excited. I brought my color wheel. We have...
Stop for one second. We need to wish Charlie that he feels better.
You're still sick?
Charlie feels better.
He was really sick, he said, over the weekend.
Yeah, we all know how that is, and it's not fun.
Yeah, we sure do.
Ugh. I'm fine, but I still wake up and cough a little bit. But then I'm fine, like, the rest of the day. But I just can't seem to get rid of that little teeny tiny bit that's hanging in there. So, I'm done for another 2 years. I'm over.
Me too.
I'm done. Yeah. So we're going to talk about color theory, but I have a couple of things first. I have notes everywhere.
Oh my goodness. The bright yellow.
Well, I forgot to change the paper in the printer. So
obviously,
and I still haven't changed it. Our good friend Judy stopped by to pick up her order, and she brought something for you two. Because she didn't want you to feel left out.
How cute are
you?
You
remember Judy made me these mug rugs? She made one for each of you.
That is so sweet.
She said, I saw Barb's hand grab that rug away from you.
They're beautiful.
Yes.
She does beautiful. She does beautiful.
So thank you, Judy.
Thank you, Judy.
You're not here yet, but thank you.
She'll be here. Yes, she came over to pick up her order, and she said, here, I have something for Barb and Marlene, too. I don't want them to be left out.
You must have been reading my mind. I was going to call you.
That's beautiful.
And I love surprises in the mail, especially when I have no idea what I'm getting. And look at this beautiful scarf.
Oh, wow.
Isn't this beautiful?
Wow, an affinity scarf.
And it's a pretty color.
It is.
And it works nicely. And we're going to talk about color, and I'll tell you why I like this one so much. And this, thank you. And I'll explain why today. See, Marlene said it was a good color on me. She's right. I will say she is right. Marianne made this for me, and...
Isn't
that beautiful?
Very nice.
And it's squishy. It's so squishy.
It is. Yeah.
Like,
my favorite color is purple.
I'm not excited.
Mine's teal and aqua.
You don't wear scarves.
I'm not excited to wear it because if I wear it, there's a reason why.
Yeah.
But I am going to wear it. So I've been leaving it here.
Judy is here.
Oh,
this
good.
Is beautiful. Thank you.
You're welcome.
And Trisha, I forgot to bring it with me, but she sent me I thought I had it this morning. She sent me just a nice little, you know, happy holiday thank you for the retreat card. And, ow, my leg stuck.
Jesus.
Your handwriting is beyond.
Yeah,
it's
really,
gorgeous. Gorgeous. And the card, it was one of her homemade cards.
Yep.
Handmade cards. And it has a yellow lab really zoomed in on it. I don't know whose dog that is, Trisha. I assume yours, but I want to snuggle that face. I just want to kiss him. So, thank you. Thank you very much. Before we get into our talk about color theory, I have some restocks. Just wanted to let you know.
Yes.
For those of you at the retreat asking, rainbow zippers are back. I didn't even know that we were out of them until one of you asked me, so thank you. I don't always notice things. So they are back. They're on the website.
I guess we missed it, too.
You know, it happens. We're very busy. We forget things sometimes. We also got navy cork. We got the house cork. We got a little bit of unicorn tears. We did not order a ton of it, but I have a little tiny bit if you're looking for that. And we have a lot more coming. I can't even tell you how much, but there will be a massive amount of cork being delivered here, guaranteed on the same day, because that's how it always goes. No. We go from nothing to all of it. So I will have a lot of cutting to do, but that's okay. It's because of you guys, so that's fine. We ordered a couple new things, but mostly restocks because we are wiped out.
Yeah,
so sure. We have cork coming all the time. We have several orders. I think.
Just so
oh,
you know, for future reference, it's freezing on some people. It's nothing for us, but just so you're aware.
It is a Facebook thing,
yeah.
And I can't help it. I have no idea why. It's not our internet, surprisingly.
Nope.
It's a Facebook thing because when I watch the videos or upload them to YouTube, it doesn't do it, so it must even itself out. So I'm sorry. I can't fix it, though. Okay. I did have a couple other things. The handmade holiday. I have seen a lot of you posting your gifts. I'm going to go through today and double check on people's posts that I haven't seen and start sending some emails and checking in. If you haven't sent your gift or if you haven't received your gift, please send me an email before I send you one, if just to let me know. And then I'm just trying to check everything off. Like I said, I understand that things happen, but you have to tell me. If you have not received yours, let me know. I will touch base with your partner. If you have received yours and you haven't posted it to Facebook, please do that. It's the only thing I ask of you, just so that your partner knows that their hard work is not for nothing, and it's out there, and we all get to see it and ooh and ah, because it's been really, really fun. I don't know about you guys, but I love when I get a notification. I'm like, oh, it's a swap thing.
Yep.
So you guys are having a great time, and we want to see everything. So I'm going to be touching base with you guys, but if you get a chance to, send me an email and let me know, hey, my partner got her swap. It was delivered, but she hasn't said anything. Or, I haven't had a chance to send mine out yet. I will send it out tomorrow. Just let me know what's going on. And our in-person January retreat, which is going to be here. It's next month. Like,
next
it's
month.
Weird
it's
to say it's next month. It's not even a full month away.
No.
It's next, the next month. We actually have 3 spots open. Now, however, it still says sold out on the website. And the reason is we have a lot of people that come as day trippers, and then we have people that stay. We can do either or. And so instead of me opening it up and then having it over full, because we don't want to have no room or turn anybody away. If you are interested, please send me an email. I will get you all settled up and we'll figure out what you need to do. But we have 3 spots left.
Yep.
And we know this because Barb had a retreat and she knows exactly how many people can fit.
Yep.
And we underestimated just to be sure.
Yeah.
But comfortably, we have 3 more spots.
Yep.
So if your friends are coming and you want to come with them, you can come with us. We're all going, right?
Right.
We're all
yeah.
good?
Yep.
All right. And for those of you that were in the retreat over the weekend, the virtual retreat, and anybody who had asked afterwards, are we doing more? Yes. I have not listed anything. It is the 10th of December. I am still trying to get my Christmas sewing done. So as soon as I can catch up with myself, either right after the holidays or right after the first of the year, I will put up dates for the virtual. I've already been going through my calendar and figuring out what weekends are going to work. So if you're interested, they will be posted. They're just not up yet.
Are we going to do more in-person retreats with you?
Well, I would like to, but I don't know what the in-person schedule looks like between your stuff, my stuff, and the hotels. But
I'll start looking into it.
We will, yes,
yeah, yeah.
For sure. Basically, I'm just tagging along on Barb's retreats and bringing some product with me. That's it. And I'm there to answer questions. I mean, let's be real here. They're Barb's retreats, but I just throw my name on there because I'm that person. I'm like the group, like when you do a group project with someone and you do all the work and I just get my name on there, it's kind of like that.
That's it.
Okay.
No,
so
you provide the goodie bags.
I do provide the goodie bags,
yeah.
Yes. And I think they're pretty good goodie bags. I think we excel at goodie bags.
I think you excel at
so,
goodie bags for sure.
I'll take it. So
yeah.
Okay.
You definitely excel at goodie
oh,
bags.
Oh, one more thing, and then we're gonna talk about color theory and color wheels, because I think we all need to talk about that. Oh, 2 more things. I keep touching this. No, I just wanted to show you. Isn't this pretty?
It is pretty. I noticed it earlier.
Yeah.
My friend made these for me, and I'm going to tag her because she has an Etsy shop. She's local, and she's an actual friend. Like, I know her in real life. I held her baby, and we were in weddings together. We know each other, like, for real. Not just, like, an online friend like you guys. We're, like, an in-person friend. She started a jewelry business which reminds me that I used to make jewelry, and sometimes I look at it and I'm like, oh, I miss it, and then I don't have enough time. Mm-hmm. So I would rather buy her pretty jewelry. It is excellently priced, fast shipping. She's local to me, but she has an Etsy shop, and so I've been wearing a lot of her earrings. I love earrings. Mm-hmm. So I've been wearing earrings, and I got this necklace, so I wanted to show you. Thank you, Robin, if you're watching, but I will tag her in case you want to go look at her stuff. And I said there was one more thing, and now I don't know what it was.
What's the name of her Etsy shop?
I believe it's RTS Designs, but I'm going to tag it to make sure that that is correct, because I say things wrong all the time. But I'm 99% sure it is RTS. I had another thing. And then I touched my necklace, and then I lost my brain. Oh,
I found it. We found it.
I know you won't remember. I'll remind you again next week, and I will remind you as much as I can. Next week, the 17th, is going to be the last Facebook Live of the year, because the next Friday is Christmas Eve, and the Friday after that is New Year's Eve. And while I don't participate in most of that stuff myself, I'm going to give myself 2 weeks off. I had 2 weeks off last year. Not off. I'm still here. I'm still doing stuff. I still post. But just to gather myself and think of more ideas, maybe I'd love to rearrange everything and have a new backdrop in January. I don't know. But I just want to let you know that. So don't be sad. You can watch reruns. And I do
just
have...
Like on TV.
That's what we were joking about yesterday was, why don't we rerun our Christmas episode? Last year in Log Cabin, because we're having a little get together with the four of us, and all we're thinking is food. So it's going to be very distracting trying to do a video thinking and smelling all the food. So it's okay. So we have this week, we have next week, which is a mystery still because it always is. And then I am going to take 2 weeks off. I will remind you guys. So because yes,
are we working Christmas?
Two weeks from today is Christmas Eve.
I'm not.
I don't care. It's that's your decision.
You have a life.
So
I know you don't have a life, and I do.
We'll worry about those two afterwards. But we will not have a Facebook Live video on the 24th or the 31st. Be nice, ladies.
No.
Yes. Okay. So today we're going to talk about the color wheel. We're going to talk about color theory. I'm going to go through this color lecture that I have done. Some of it might seem more geared towards like quilters and things, because remember, usually when I give these lectures, it's in front of a group of quilters, but it doesn't matter. Color theory applies to everything in our life. So even if I say something about a quilt and you're not a quilter, it doesn't matter. This is a general lecture, and I love doing this one because I went to art school. That was what I did in college. I majored in interior design. That's what I did for 12 years before I started my business. I think that's why I'm comfortable with colors, because it's been a part of my life, and it was a part of high school when I did art classes and college and my career. So I'm very comfortable putting colors together, but I know that a lot of other people are not. So what we did today, I brought my color wheel because a lot of people buy them and then don't know how to use them and don't know what to do with them. Barb's raising her hand. And a lot of people think, I want to get one, but like, do I need one? I'm not going to say you need to have a color wheel, but is it, you know, they're like 10 bucks. Like, is it a big deal to have that on hand to help you out? What I like about the color wheel is that it's going to help you in picking colors, but it also gives you an explanation, and I'm going to explain it to you as well. Some of what we talk about today, some of it is my opinion, and I will tell you when it's my opinion. Some of it is like actual terminology that I learned in art college that you'll see on the internet. There's no quiz. You don't need to remember all of it, but just in case you hear things,
there's no test,
Barb. But just in case you hear it, you're like, I'm familiar with that word. I know what that means. So one of the things that I wanted to do is talk about how to use a color wheel. I just wanted to show you because I forgot that I had this. This is my color wheel.
Or your big one. I remember seeing
this. This is my color wheel when I do lectures, because you never know the size of your room. But don't worry, I'm not using this today.
I love that one.
Isn't it awesome? It's huge.
Yeah.
So I forgot about it, and I was like, wait, I have a gigantic color wheel. I'm not using that today. But when I stand up in front of a room full of people and they're not all close, it helps. Because I usually hold this up first, and then they're all going...
I said, hold on,
I can help you out. So there are several different color wheels available. If you go on Amazon and you just search color wheel, this is the one that I like because I think it's the easiest to use. Some of them have a lot of extra information and it gets a little overwhelming. This one is by the Color Wheel Company. That's their name. It's two-sided. Both sides have some stuff for you. So this side has a lot of information. which we'll go over. And this shows you when you're adding a color to another color, what it becomes. This is the side that I think is more helpful. This is the side here that's going to show you complementary colors, analogous colors, what is a triad, and we're going to talk about all of those things. So this side is the side that I use more and that you would probably use more. For each of the colors, it's going to show you kind of light to dark, and it gives you some ideas, and you can spin this, and you can put different combinations together. So we'll do that as we go along so that it makes a little bit more sense. And then Barb and Marlene and I picked a few things that we're also going to talk about. So I'm going to read through my notes because it is 3 pages and I just don't want to forget anything because I haven't done this official lecture in a while. So I'm just going to take a look and just make sure that I get everything. Yes, I'm talking to myself. Okay, so one of the things that I want you to remember, and I tell you this a lot, color is personal, just like choices of anything that we make, how we dress, what car we drive, where we live. It is a personal choice. None of you are wrong. I don't want you to think, because one of the things that we're going to do is show you a color combination that each of us does not like. If you like it, we're not making fun of you. We're not telling you you're wrong, but it doesn't appeal to me or it doesn't appeal to Marlene, and that's fine. And we're going to tell you why it doesn't. And it might make you go, well, I kind of like that together, and that's fine. There is nothing about this that is going to, I don't want you to feel bad about it. If you pick colors and you like them, that's literally all that matters. If you're happy with your bag, your quilt, your whatever you're making, that is all that matters. But understanding the color wheel, if you feel a little challenged in that area, or if you just kind of, you don't know where to start and you get a little overwhelmed, understanding why certain colors look differently with other colors, it helps you to make better decisions. I have some bags here. You have to understand a lot of my bags get kind of boring on the inside because I'm just making samples, but I wanted to pick some that had different prints because a lot of people are kind of shy about adding prints together. I think as a quilter, I think we kind of don't care because a lot of our quilts have multiple prints, but some of you are not quilters. So I'll show you those as well after we go through everything. So let me just go through this. Look at this real quick. Yes, okay. So we're gonna start with the basics. And some of you might know this. If you are my husband, you did not know this. He tried really hard, but he did not know. I will ask you two, do you know what the primary colors are? There's 3 of them.
Red, yellow, and blue.
No. Perfect. Yeah. Red, yellow, and blue. Mm-hmm. Why are they the primary colors? Because they are the 3 colors that make everything else. Yeah. So when you look at your color wheel, there's a triangle that says complementary, and it says split complementary, and then it says triad. Triad, tri is 3. If I point that arrow to red, then it goes to blue and it goes to yellow. Mm-hmm. Your 3 primary colors make everything. Then you have your secondary colors, which are purple, orange, and green. Those colors are made from your primary colors, and then everything else goes from there. So when you look at a color wheel, you will start with red. It goes in rainbow order. We don't just go red to orange. There's red, orange in between. And there's a color in between each one. And honestly, because there's so many colors in the world, we could do a color in between red and red, orange. There's colors in between everything. So we've got our red, our yellow, and our blue that make everything. We've got our orange, our violet. I just always say purple. Violet's the technical color. Mm-hmm. And green, which are our secondary colors. Those make triads because there are 3. I'm checking my notes again. Just making sure I don't skip anything because I get excited. So, and then we have the tertiary colors, which is a weird word to say. But those are your in-between colors. So in between red and violet, red, violet. It's just that easy. So one of the best ways to look at this and to use this, because oftentimes in bags, we're not going to use 3 colors. A lot of times we're going to use 2 colors. You know, we might have a print where we pull a color from. We'll get into that. But we might want to just do 2 colors. There's, I don't know which bag. Well, the Rue bucket bag, for instance. We have a color on the bottom and we have an accent color. Mm-hmm. A lot of times it's a print because prints are fun. But maybe you just want to do it out of 2 colors. I don't know what colors are going to look good together. Well, my favorite color is red violet. Out of all the purples, I like that one. Mm-hmm. So if I just move this over, actually, hold on. Gotta move it correctly. There we go. And I just look across. Yellow green is a complementary color. I know that when I put those two colors together, I'm going to get a big pop. I'm going to get the most contrast because they are the complete opposite of each other. They are day and night. And if that's the look I'm going for, imagine if I did that in a really great red purple, or, you know, red violet, like a cool fabric, and I put a yellow green band around the top. It's going to pop. But that's not really what I want. I want to go a little bit more subtle. We have other options. So, one of the other options that you can get into, hold on, I'm skipping a few things here. You can do, like we said, a triad, which that's a lot. I don't know if I want to add a third color to this. Let's see. Hold on. So if I did a triad, I would have a red violet. Get over there. There we go. It's very hard when you drink backwards. I would have red violet. I would have yellow orange, which I'm all right with. I don't mind that. Mm-hmm. And then I would have blue-green. That's kind of fun. It's not going to be as intense as that green, but maybe I can mix those three in together because I always like to start with a color that I like. What color do I want to start with? And where do I want to go? Do I want, bam, big contrast? Or do I want a little contrast? I don't know. Which way do I want to go? One of the things that I always do a lot in quilting is using kind of colors next to each other. You can go with cool colors, which are going to be your watercolors, or you can go with warm colors. But if I want to start here and I want to add more colors, I kind of just have to decide how I want to add those. Do I want pop or do I want them to be a little bit more subtle? And that's, I think, the biggest question is what is the end goal that you're looking for? So let me go backwards for just a second here. So when you use colors, you basically have one of two things that you're going to achieve. You are either going for contrast or you're harmonizing, which is blending them. So when I'm doing my contrast, I'm using complete opposites, okay? If I want them to harmonize, there's different ways that I can do it. Maybe this is too much. I don't want this combination. I want to do something a little bit different. So what I can do is I can go with warm colors again. Warm is anything that is associated with fire, which can get a little tricky because do I go into the red violet since it's got red? Do I stop here? But I usually say anything red, orange, or yellow, anything on that half of the spectrum is going to be a fire color. It's going to be warm. I could also go to the cool colors. I can do my blues and my greens and my violets over here. So if I do those, it's going to be much more harmony. It's going to be quieter because there isn't that pop of color in there. Some people like a pop of color. Some people like it to be a little bit more subtle. And when it comes to prints, you don't really have to worry about those two colors right next to each other. You can decide based on the print. Let's say we have a print that has a ton of blue in it. It's got all different colors, but blue is the one that stands out. Well, do I want to go something in the orange to really make that pop? Do I want to go with the blue to pull the blues out of the print? It's hard to say what, because there isn't a right answer. And I'm going to do this now. We each picked a color that we like for the house cork, okay? So this is going to be the main part of my bag, okay? I picked tomato. Now, red is not my favorite color. I say that all the time. But I think I don't like blue reds, and I don't like deep, deep, like those kinds of reds. I like orange reds because I like orange. So when I put that in there, I'm pulling out some of those reds, but I feel like I'm also getting a little bit of pop with the green because it's the opposite. Mm-hmm. What color did you pick?
The green.
The green.
The dark green.
Okay, so Barb went dark, and she picked the dark green. Now, the dark green is not technically in this print, but that's okay because there's so many colors in here. Why did you pick this one? You just like this color, or was there something here?
Plus, I like the way it went with the green roofs and stuff.
So the green roofs.
Not that one, the other one.
Where?
The darker one.
Here?
That one. Yeah.
This, when you look up close,
is
actually like a teal, but to Barb it looked green, and it does, and it probably on camera looks green.
She's colorblind.
I don't think she's colorblind, but we'll have her checked. But when you put it on there, this gives it, look at the difference.
Yeah, it looks totally different.
When you go to a darker, cool color. Am I right and is Barb wrong? No, it's just differences in what we selected. We can also go
use that with it. It looks nice.
With the different green. So that's going to change right there. Mm-hmm. That's going to give us two different looks. Mm-hmm. This is a great print, something like this that has a lot of colors for any of you that are unsure, that are a little bit uneasy about picking colors, because there is no wrong answer. There is not a color that you could pick to go with this that would go, ugh, that's bad, because there's every color in here. And there's some dark purple in here. Well, what if we pick this? It's not the same purple. It's not quite it, but you can use it. It's fine. And it doesn't, I can justify and go, well, there's a little bit right there. But when you pick a print like this, or the rainbow butterflies, garden bloom, what other ones? I'm trying to think, cork that has lots of colors. The bluebirds, any of those that have tons and tons of colors, it makes it a little bit easier for you because you're not worried, does this match? Mm-hmm. These all match. They all match just fine. And Mara, what did you pick?
I picked the orange.
Which I love with this too. And there's an orange in here. It's a little bit peachier, but that's okay. Sometimes I think we have to stop being matchy-matchy. And that's not a bad thing. Don't take that to be a bad thing. But sometimes we get it in our head that, well, this green is not exactly the same. Like, that's a little bit bluer, mm-hmm. So is this green not right? Do you like this together? Then it's right. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to always match. And Cindy, I don't know if Cindy's watching, but Cindy had emailed me about this mm-hmm. and said that one of the things, and it's one of her, you know, her things, is that she always feels like she has to match. It has to be perfect. If that's what makes you happy, then do that, but it also can make you crazy. So don't think that any of the rest of us are ever going to notice that green is a little bit more yellow and that green's a little bit more blue. It really doesn't matter. You just have to like it together. Try to open up a little bit more and be a little bit more flexible. And then you're not going to make yourself so crazy. Sometimes it's awesome and you get like a perfect match. And that doesn't happen very often, but it's like, hey, look at that. Even this, not perfect, but that's pretty close. That's mm-hmm. pretty close. Sometimes that just happens by chance. So, here, I'm going to give you that back. We're not quite at that. We have mm-hmm. another thing that we're going to do. Thing. So we have to get our cork here together. So, is this making sense to everybody so far? Mm-hmm. Is anybody just walking away and saying, I can't do it anymore?
Nope.
Okay, good. So, two words that drive me a little crazy, only because I know exactly what you're trying to say, but I know what they actually mean, and I'm just gonna tell you, and maybe you can, you know, dazzle your friends with all of your new knowledge. Hue, H-U-E, is literally just another word for color. It's the same thing. Mm-hmm. So when you say, I need a different hue, you're looking for a different color. Mm-hmm. So if you're ever not sure what that means, that's all that means. Tint, we don't use tint a lot, but we use the opposite. Tint is when you add white to something. That's all that it is. So if I add white to this, I get a lighter version of this green. The one that everyone uses, and we're all guilty of it, we have all done it, shade. I need green, but I need a different shade of green.
Yeah.
What shade actually means is that you've added black to the color. So it means a darker green. 99% of the population knows that that means I just need a different color green. This green is good, but it's not the right green. What other shades of green do you have? So I know, because I remember doing this in high school art class and my teacher hating when we would say that. He would get very annoyed. It's not a shade unless you're adding black. Stop saying you need a different shade of green. I'm like, but it's an easier way to say it. So that is what it actually means. So if anybody ever corrects you, now you know why. But most of the time when we say a different shade, we mean a different color. We use it interchangeably. Tone, on the other hand, means that we've added gray to it. So tone is different. So if I said I need a different tone of gray, I want something more gray, less gray, I'm adding gray to it. Just silly terminology, just in case you ever wanted to know what any of that means. So we talked about complementary colors. Complementary colors, which are directly across from each other on the color wheel. I always can remember if I start with red and green, because it's Christmas. Mm-hmm. So if I start with red and green, I can kind of work my way around. So purple and orange and blue and yellow. So it's easy that way. Now here's something leading back to what Marlene said earlier. Marlene said, that's a great color on you. Do you want to know why? Because I have green eyes. Because my eyes are green. And when I wear oranges, because my eyes are a little bit on the blue side, when I wear those kinds of colors, it makes my eyes stand out. I have orange and a little bit of burgundy on my eyes today. It makes them look more green because I'm picking the polar opposite. Because when you look on here, my eyes are not green. They're more in this blue green. What's directly across from it? Red orange.
Yeah.
So for me personally, I'm not a fan of red. I do look good in red, and I really hate that I do because I just don't like red. I never buy it. The few times I try it on, I'm like, ugh, it looks good. Whatever. So look at your eye color when you're looking at different shirts. You're getting a photograph taken. Color theory applies to everything. And, oh, would you do me a favor?
Yeah.
Would you grab my purse for me? I brought something. It's on the chair over here. Yes. Oh, yeah, just watch the cord. On that little chair there. I want to show you something else about complementary colors. Now, this is a makeup thing, and this will make sense to anybody this will make sense to anybody who's ever been in the makeup aisle. I'm going to explain something to you that you might not have known, or maybe you do. And Charlie and any of my non-makeup wearers, I'm sorry. And Charlie, I'm not judging. Maybe Charlie likes makeup. Have you ever seen these before?
No.
Okay, these are color correcting sticks. Mm-hmm. And you probably thought to yourself, what am I supposed to do with those in the makeup aisle? Why is there a green and an orange stick? I'm going to put that on my face. Well, guess what? What is the opposite color of green? It's red.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if I have a pimple or I have a red spot, if I take this and put it on there and then put my makeup over it, it gets rid of the red. So I'm not enhancing it because I'm putting it over the top. I'm blending it in. And you know those dark circles you got under your eyes? This right here, because it's orange, and a lot of times you have purple blue underneath. You put that under and you put your makeup on, and it helps to make that go away. So if you've ever walked down a makeup aisle and went, what on earth do they have green and yellow and orange sticks for? You're using the opposite color on your face to subdue the things that you're trying to hide. So you got a big old pimple, you put that green on there, cover it up, and it helps to hide it. So I wanted to tell you that.
What do you use for the age spot?
More foundation. Well, what color are they?
Well, look at me. Like this one here, they're like brown.
So you could probably try a little bit of that, or let's see, because brown is actually an orange.
Yep.
So what is across from here is the blues and green. So you could try a little bit of the green if you wanted to. There's not always a cut and dry answer, but you got to be creative. So I brought my color correctors with me today. As I'm putting my makeup on, I was like, wait, there's a lesson here. So, and if you don't wear makeup and you have no idea what I'm talking about, just fast forward. Just move on. All right. So, yes.
Charlie's got a comment.
Yes.
On Drag Race, the queens put orange on first to hide their shadow.
See? You know. That's how it goes, because you're hiding the thing that's underneath. So when I put my eyeshadow on today, I'm putting it around the green. I'm pulling orange here. I'm making my eyes pop. If I wanted to cover up something and I put it over top, it cancels it. So it's not something that's necessarily going to apply to everything in your life or anything unless you use color correcting sticks, but I'm just letting you know. A lot of times, and I used to hear this because I have been into makeup my whole life, I'd meet somebody that I worked with or whatever, and they'd say, I don't know what color eyeshadow to wear. I'm like, well, look at your eye color. Why don't you try this? You know, try something. What do you want to do with it?
Let me see your color wheel.
Yes, Marlene wants the color wheel. So all of this is too much, and you're not quite ready for it, and you don't know what you want
to
do.
So I have to wear teal eyeshadow?
If you, well, we could do a little eyeliner.
That's like 1960s.
It's back. Don't worry. So, don't worry. I'll help you out.
My eyes. Kind of
And now we've gone into a whole totally
you
different thing.
Like kind of easily.
Like
oh, but I don't want to wear orange.
It's a good color. That's offensive. Okay, so let's talk about some of the colors that are going to be a little bit easier for everybody to put together. Some of the color schemes. The easiest one, I think the easiest one possible. If you're putting stuff together, monochromatic. And I don't have an example because monochromatic is that. Mono means one. So I want to make a bag in green. And I'm not comfortable. I don't want to put red with it. It's too Christmassy. I don't want to pick something. I don't know what to do. I'm not sure. What do I want to do? What if I did a couple different greens? I could just do some greens.
Mm-hmm.
And we had a bag. I don't know what I did with it. And it was the cork. We don't have the cork anymore. So, and this, you're... Now, you might be going, but wait.
Yeah, but it's just happened to be handy.
Wait a minute. No, I don't have it. The butterfly cork that we used to have that was all green butterflies, that to me, that's a monochromatic cork.
Yeah.
I did a bag with these two because then I didn't have to pick. Now, what if I had done that bag? I mean, this is similar enough. This is the hexagon. the hexagon has all different blues. So here's a monochromatic scheme. I want something that goes, I want like a big pop. I want something bold. I'm going to throw orange in there because I want it to be in my face. But on second thought, that's too much. I don't like that. Well, what if I pull some green? Mm-hmm. It's kind of monochromatic because this has some blues and greens, but it's also staying in that same zone. This feels a little bit more comfortable. And I didn't go with navy, and I didn't pick one of the aquas. I went with something very close. You can do that. It's kind of, you pull your neighbor over, and you know, what's next to you on the color wheel? So monochromatic is a great way to go, whether you're doing solid colors or you're doing a print, because some of our prints are monochromatic prints. It's easy enough to do that. One of the other ones that I love, and I'm going to show you on the color wheel so it makes a little bit more sense, is called analogous. And the way that you're going to remember analogous is a group of friends. They're all hanging out together, right? So we could pick 3 to 5, okay?
Really?
Pick a color. Pick any color.
Purple.
Violet? You want to go with want to be a purist?
I want to be a purist.
Okay. Marlene picked violet, which is no surprise to anybody, mm-hmm. but that's okay. So Marlene, do you like blue violet or red violet? You can say both.
Red violet.
Okay, so Marlene likes these two. Yep. All right, do we want to go back to blues or we want to go more into reds? What other color do you like in our scheme that's right next to it?
The red.
Okay, so Marlene is going towards the reds. So we started with violet, we went to red violet, we went to red. That's fine, we can stop there. Or if Marlene wants to keep going, she can go more into, sorry, I keep getting the wrong one, this little thing in the way. Turn. There we go. So if Marlene wants to, we can go more and pick up a little bit of orange, or we can go more towards the blues and do some more blue. We're hanging out together. We're picking 3 to 5 colors that are right next to each other. Then there's going to be something that's called analogous complementary. Now we know complementary means opposite. So let's say that we have a group of friends, okay? We're gonna go with our group of friends here, but we're bringing in someone that we don't know that well, okay? We're gonna bring in a stranger. So this is Marlene's color scheme right here. We're gonna pick one of these colors and pick the opposite.
She's bad.
So we're gonna go with violet and we're gonna add yellow. So what that means is I picked a little group of friends and I pulled in a stranger. That's all. I have someone else to hang out with me. Now let me show you, because I have some quilt pictures that might help you to see this a little bit better. Mm. Okay, so let's go back. Okay, so we talked about complementary. So I picked my reds and I picked my greens. Now just because I'm looking at red and green doesn't mean I have to do red and green. I pick different greens, I put in a little bit of pink. I'm in that same zone. Complementary in a color scheme, you don't have to pick only red and only green. You can branch out a little bit. Here's my, hold on, I don't want this one. Here's my triad. There's my three colors. I'm still getting a lot of pop, and I just picked, and my colors would technically be my purple or violet, green and orange, and I went with the ones that I liked. I have a little bit more blue, I have a little bit more red, I've got a little deeper, a little lighter, some different greens. They don't have to be exactly what is on the color wheel, but use that as a guide, as a starting point. Kind of like when I tell you guys we have kits. Maybe you don't want to buy that kit, but something about that picture you like, but you want to add something different, use that as something to inspire you. There's a lot of you that buy patterns to use it exactly for how it's written. Start to finish, I make the pattern exactly as it is, and that's it, and that's fine. Some of you like to buy the pattern and mix it up. I want to do a zipper instead of a divided pocket. I want to add a different kind of hardware. I want to make it shorter, taller, whatever. Either use the color wheel to really guide you step by step because you feel more comfortable, or use it as a very loose starting point, okay? But if you have a color wheel, at least I hope now you'll understand a little bit more how to use that. Because it's not hard, but it just gets it's a little confusing when you look at this and go, okay, what do I do with it? On the back here, right here, primary colors, secondary colors, tertiary, warm, cool. Over here, harmonious color schemes, monochromatic, analogous, complementary, split complementary, triad, tetrad, and key color. Those are going to be some different ones. They explain what they mean, and then they point to different things. So you don't have to remember what I'm telling you. You can see it on there. So we talked about analogous. So here, because I also like purple.
Really handy for when you're doing one of these mystery quilts like I've been doing.
Because I can't do mystery stuff. It stresses me out.
Not really sure what you're going to be doing, but at least you know the colors will go together.
Here is the color scheme Marlene picked out. No, I did not plan this. We both like purple. Yeah. So here's my analogous. Here's my red violet, my blue violet, my violet. I picked a few colors that I like together. But I also went and did my analogous complementary. So you see how I've got all purples here? And then here, I did a little pop of that yellow in there because it's the complementary color to my purples. Mm-hmm. And if I look at my color wheel, move this again, it's always in my way. I can use this group of colors. So I went from red violet all the way to yellow green. I picked a big chunk. I have a lot of pictures here. Hold on. Listen. I did a warm color scheme, which is also analogous because I stuck with the warm colors, but they're all neighbors, right? Mm-hmm. So this is my friends, and here's my friends with a little bit of pop. Now in this is kind of a made up color scheme that I do. I picked all my warm colors right here, but this was a little bit too subtle. I want something more. There's my pop. I just randomly pick opposite colors. So since everything was warm, I went with some cool colors to make some pop. That's like a little made up thing that I do. It's kind of analogous, but not. Another warm with a pop of color. There's your aquas. I pulled them in, okay?
Oh, that went through.
So, hold on, we're gonna go back to my notes here. Because I have some of my favorites. So as I showed you, pop. I love, especially when I have the option to add a lot of colors, which I know in bag making, we don't always have that option, but I love adding little pops of color. One of my favorite things to do is black and white with a pop of color. Mm-hmm. So in our cork fabrics and in bag making, we don't do a ton of black and white prints, but we have a lot of natural with black. You know, we have a lot of like one color printing. Most people gravitate towards red. How many quilts have you seen that are black, white, and red?
Oh, yeah.
There's nothing wrong with that, but I don't like red. So instead of me throwing red in there, I go with some other color. I put green, hot pink, orange, yellow, whatever I'm feeling. We have, yes, that one right behind me. Would you grab it?
Yeah.
Yes. So I could have done red with this, absolutely, but instead, I put the hot pink because this is more me. Now, you might be going, I don't really like hot pink. I don't like it. Barb could put aqua or teal here. Marlene could put one of the purples here. So it's a kind of a gradual way to work yourself into being more comfortable with color. Pick a neutral scheme and throw in a color that you like because you're not going to go wrong. Neutrals, your blacks, your grays, your browns, navies, those are all neutrals. You're not going to be wrong to put any color in with that. Do you disagree? I mean, mm-hmm. really. Mm-hmm. We do have like the paw print cork and the black and white polka dots yep. that are your true black and white. And there is a Fiona kit where I use the lemon yellow. Mm-hmm. I mean, would normal people use a pastel lemon yellow with a black and white? Maybe not. But I was like, why do a bright color? It doesn't always have to be bright. So that was, for me, one of my things. I also, especially in quilting, I do a lot of rainbow and partial rainbow. And I understand that rainbow sometimes is a lot for people, all these colors together. So what I call it is a partial rainbow. I take out a color. I just kind of go, I'm going to get rid of, again, the red. I'm going to stick with pink, or I'm just going to skip it. And I'm just going to kind of use that chunk of colors. Because really, what it comes down to, it's analogous. They're all next to each other. I'm just removing the one that I don't like. Because you don't have to use colors you don't like, ever. I do when I make samples because I try to get outside of my comfort zone on your behalf. But do you two get out of your comfort zone in the most of the time?
No.
If you're making it for yourself, no. Because no. Barb likes aqua. Why is she going to force herself to carry a bag that's orange if she's like, that's not the color I like? Yeah. You don't have to use colors you don't like. I don't know if you all knew that or not, but I wanted to make sure that you did. Sometimes it's hard. One of the other things that I think is an easy thing to do is sticking with a tone. And what I mean by that is pastel. I could put any pastel color in here. It's not going to be wrong because they're all in that same tone. So if I wanted to pull in a peach or a pink or a butter yellow, I can. Now, if I threw in hot pink, it's going to look really weird in here because it's not the same tone. It's going to be a little odd by itself, right? You can also, I love jewel tones, and I think our cork is definitely more toward, more geared towards jewel tones. How beautiful is that? They're jewel tones. There's nothing wrong with that. For me, I'm not a huge pastel fan. It's they don't appeal to me. Jewel tones and whatever you want to name it in between, like in between a jewel tone and a pastel, kind of just like that, I don't know, that happy warm. I like that. You just pick what you like. That's really the whole point of this whole thing is just pick what you like. I'm just going to look here, see what else. I always have a lot of tips. I always tell quilters, if you don't know where to go and where to start, pick from a collection. And that also applies to bag making. So this is a bag that I made a while ago because I had this entire collection. It was a Tula Pink collection. Yes, it's a lot of prints. It's a lot of prints together. But she designed this in one collection. I saw this all together. It works. I'm using the same designer. I'm using her same collection. So it's easy enough to pick from that collection. I could have added more. I could have done the handles in a different color. I could have added, you know, other colors here. But if you pick from the same collection, the designer's already done the work for you. They've already picked these fabrics to go in a group together. So if you go to your local quilt shop or fabric store and you see a group together, they're put together for a reason. Pre-cuts, we've talked a little bit about pre-cuts. It's one of each of that collection. They all go together because they were designed that way. So it's a good place to start. Let me see what else. Here's another thing that's a nice, easy way if you're still unsure about colors. Instead of worrying about the outside, I picked the lining fabric. And all I did was pick colors from the lining fabric that worked. Now, gray is a neutral. Gray goes with everything. And the hot pink is part of that print. So I started with the lining and kind of worked my way backwards because I knew that I had some options here. I could have picked orange. I could have picked a blue. There's like a lime green in here. I could have picked anything in here to do this center. And I went with gray. There isn't gray in here, but it had a lot of gray to the tone of the colors. So I thought the gray looked nice. And gray's neutral. Neutrals always work. Now, let's talk about putting prints together. Because this is something that is hard for some people. I know that. I'm pretty bold, so I don't care about, I like putting different prints together. So I did this bag. I still love this bag. And I picked the leopard print, okay? This is the old leopard print. This is the bigger one that we don't carry anymore. This right here is actually black, and I went with chocolate. Because I can, because it's my bag. Because the logical thing for a lot of people would be to make this black. That's fine. But I didn't want to make it black. I wanted to use, I love the chocolate brown. So I picked that because this is all neutral, so I can do anything I want. And I picked the caramel because it's in there, okay? So now that I've done that, what do I want to do for a lining? I could go beige. I could go really basic.
Go crazy.
I put floral. That Why? Because I wanted to. Because the flowers in here, now, there really is no neutral. There's like a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of like the caramel color. It doesn't necessarily match. It's bold. But why can't I put flowers inside of my leopard print bag? Mm-hmm. Like, is there a rule that says I can't?
No.
I can do whatever I want. So for this, if you're not comfortable, maybe you want to go a little bit more subtle. Maybe you want to bring in a print that's not a bold print. You could bring in something that just has like a little tiny something. I went bold. I picked the flowers. And one of the things, Charlie has said this a couple times, and some of you have said this, is those prints sometimes that we get, they're very bold. They might not be something we want on the outside of a bag. Put it on the inside. It's kind of a nice way to break yourself into playing with prints because you just, you know, kind of try it out here before you put it out here. I love this, but would I get tired of this on the outside of the bag? I might. It's also light. I wanted to keep it inside. So I put flowers with leopard print. This one right here.
You're crazy.
I'm crazy. This one right here, I used one of the printed corks with the print on the canvas. Because this is a subtle print, and this is, it's not a bold print, but it's a lot more bold than this. When you're playing with patterns, try to mix up your scales too. So you see that this is kind of a medium scale, and this is a very small scale. My prints together, I have a multicolor print, and I have a two-color print. Just like the leopard print was about three colors, and the floral print was crazy. If you want to mix prints, I wouldn't do another flower on top of another flower on top of another flower. That's when it gets a little bit too, it's too much. If you like that, then do that. But for me, and this is my opinion, and I think I speak for Barb and Merlene, who are also shaking their heads, that would be too much. If I put flowers in here and flowers in here and flowers in here, all these multicolored prints, it's just a lot. So mixing prints, mix your scales, and mix the amount of colors that you have going on. A busy print and a not so busy print. Now, speaking of that, this is not about bag making as much as quilting. I get this a lot, and I hear this a lot if I'm at the quilt shop or when I used to do shows. This is one of those things that I have to show you on paper. I have a really bold, loud fabric, big, bold print. I want to quiet it down. How many times have we heard this? How many times have we said this? So I'm going to take that big, bold print, and I'm going to put something really small next to it because that will tone it down. Well, here's the best way that I can explain that to you. I am very loud. No. I am extremely loud, okay? If you put me in a room with other loud people, I don't seem so loud. Mm-hmm. We all blend in together. Now, if you put me in a room with quiet people, I am so much louder because I'm around all these people that are kind of quiet. And here I am yelling. So here's me standing with a bunch of quiet people. That fabric stands out to me so much because all of these are tone on tones. Here's another one. What is the first thing that you see? The loud one.
Yeah.
What about this one? I have some loud people. I have some quiet people. We all blended in together. So when you have something bold and loud, when you have yourself a Jessica, what's your goal here? If you truly want to quiet it down, put it with other things that are also loud and mix it up. If you want it to stand out, put it with quiet things. That's the best way that I can explain it to you. I can't tell you how many times over the years I have heard that.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just going to put this little polka dot or this little tone on tone next to it because it'll quiet it down. It's actually doing the opposite. So, this is going to be very controversial, but here I am. We have each picked two colors that we would never put together in a bag because for us personally, they don't appeal to us. And if it appeals to you, do not be offended because it's fine. You can even make your claim as to why we're wrong. That's fine. Here's the thing for me. I don't like pink and red together. I don't like red. And this to me always says Valentine's Day. And it's just one of those things. And I had a boss years ago that loved these colors together, wore these colors together, would have fought you on it they're fantastic. Was she right or wrong? No, it doesn't matter. For me, I look at this and I'm like, I can't do it. I can't do it. It doesn't make me happy. So why should I make myself do this? Right? Marlene, what colors do you not like together?
Well, we don't have a true red, but even a burgundy and a green scream Christmas to me. So no. I would never put them together.
Marlene does not like this, but somebody else might. Why? Because it's complementary, mm-hmm. Right? Mine is right next to each other. It's analogous, but it doesn't make me happy. Now, could we make Marlene happy? Could we make her happy with these colors?
I think... Took the green out.
Well, hear me out.
Like green.
Hear me out, okay? If we took Marlene's colors here, which we're going to call it green and red because it's just the easiest here. She doesn't like this. She doesn't want that in a bag. But she has these, and she's been challenged to use them, okay? You're challenged.
Okay.
How can we make her happy with this? Well, let's see if this makes her happy. Let's move. Okay. So, hear me out. We're going to use your green, because you don't like it.
Right.
We're going to go with a triad. We're going to pull in a little bit of orange, and we're going to pull in a little bit of violet. You like violet.
I love it.
Okay. Could we maybe add the red into this color scheme so we have a complementary and a triad and mix it together? Would that be okay with you?
Yes.
See? So we're kind of working with what we have. Now, hers are polar opposites. So it's a little bit hard because we're kind of making up a color scheme. So if I start with one and I pull in some of these and then kind of sneak that one in there, I might make Marlene, you know, a little happier. Maybe she can do the challenge and enjoy it a little bit. Now, Barb, what did you pick that you don't like? We're going to make yours work. All right. What's your beef with these?
There's no contrast at all.
Okay. Barb doesn't like that there's no contrast. So also the dark green and the purple. These are the two that she picked. So could we make you happy if we did something along here? We pulled in some of your blues.
Oh, yeah.
And we did an analogous. Yeah. So Barb, her challenge is to use these, but she doesn't like them. She has them in her stash, and she desperately wants to use them because we all want to use what we have, right? No. But she's like, so I need to prove to Marlene why I bought these. I got to use them. So maybe she can pull in and do an analogous scheme, and she can use these and not just by herself, not just use them. For me, how am I going to make me happy? Because really, the pink is kind of one. It's kind of a red. It's a tint. But if I stick over here and I pull in a little bit of this red violet, yep. I'm not so mad about that. I could do that and I would be happy about that. So if you want to try to get out of your own comfort zone and use colors you don't like, you don't have to just use those two colors. You don't have to just use that one color. I do challenge myself as often as possible to use the court colors that are here that I'm not in love with. I'm not a big red fan. I love this green and I hate this green at the same time. I have a very I have a love-hate relationship with it. I think it's beautiful. It's a grass green. It's bright. Mm-hmm. I like emeralds. Emeralds are pretty. Mm-hmm. It's a pretty color, but it doesn't appeal to me when I want to make a bag. So I try to kind of force myself to get out of my comfort zone, because if it was up to me, every sample would be purple. That's where I would stop. So try some different colors that you don't like, but gradually kind of ease yourself into it. Now, that was it. That was all the ones that I had. So I hope this kind of explains the color wheel a little bit better. Like I said, if you have one and you did not know how to use it, this little thing in the middle is going to help you. And these explanations on both sides. This side, I don't really use too much because I find that this is more for like painting, right? Mm. So I have a color and I add red to it. That's what this whole thing is. That's what adding red, and then it starts to get really ugly. like that, I don't want that color. But if as a painter or as somebody in, you know, using any kind of digital media, that helps a little bit. This talks about values. It talks about adding yellow, adding blue, adding white, adding black. Mm-hmm. It's a helpful tool, but I think this side is way more helpful. Like I said, you can find these on Amazon. Sometimes your local shops have them. They're like between $8 and $10. Now that you understand how to use it, it might help you a little bit more. But I always start with the one color that I want to work with. What do I want to work with? And I have very often walked around the shop and said, this is today's challenge. And I'll go and look at the corks and I'll pull them and I'll leave them aside and I'll pull some fabrics and I look at it. Sometimes I just want to make a purple bag or I want to make a pink bag. And I just kind of, you know, start with whatever piece inspires me. One other thing, and I think you guys all know this, but I'll tell you anyway, just in case. You do know what these little things on your selvage are, right? Mm-hmm, sometimes yes. They're dots. Sometimes mm-hmm. These are bears. That right there, I want to use this fabric in a bag, and I need another fabric. I need a contrast. I need something. I don't know where to go. If you look on your selvage at your little dots or bears or whatever they are, those are the colors that were used to print the fabric. So that's a great place to look because you know that it's going to work. On a fabric like this where there's not a lot of printing and they're pretty bold, solid colors, it's not a hard one to match. But sometimes you get some of these florals or these really busy prints and you're like, I love this print. I don't know what color to start with. I can't even tell what colors are in here. Take a look at the selvage. Canvases don't have that. I don't know why, but they don't. But most of your cotton fabrics, with the exception of batiks, have that selvage and have that little print. So if you ever wonder what that was or heard people talking about it, did not know what it is, that is what it is.
I think Shelley is being comical.
Oh, I'm sure she is.
She says, I have a question, Jess. Do you like red?
That's a fantastic question. No, I do not. Listen, I'm coming around. I'm trying, okay? Janome's color is red.
That's
right. I work with them. I'm trying really hard. But if I ever had to go to an event with them and they told me I had to wear red, it would really hurt my feelings. So I'm trying. I bought a red sweater once. Actually, I think Eric bought it for me. And it looked really nice and I got a lot of compliments. And I also had red hair once. Not that color red, but like, you know. Yeah. It makes my eyes pop. My eyes look so green when I have red hair. I can't do it. And I'm 41 years old, damn it. I am not going to force myself to do things I'm uncomfortable with.
Red nails.
I can't do red nails. I can't.
Red lipstick.
Okay. I have tried red lipstick. Uh-huh. I have. And sometimes I feel pretty and sometimes I feel like a clown and I have these huge lips. And again, here's another thing. Here's another makeup tip in case you wanted it, everybody. If you're looking for a red lipstick and you just don't like how it looks on your smile, go with a blue red, not a an orange red, because the more yellow that's in it, the more discolored it makes your teeth look. When you pick, I'm serious, when you pick a blue, even if you have the whitest teeth, if you pick a blue red, more of a cool red, it makes your teeth look whiter. So there, that's your lesson for today. You got color wheel, you got restocks, and you got makeup. What more could you ask for here? And you found out what colors Barb and Marlene don't like together. So, I don't know what else I could give you today.
I don't know.
I am going to let Barb look at the computer real quick. I'm just going to make sure I didn't forget to tell you anything. Just making sure.
Everybody is very thankful for the information.
I hope it helps. I know it's overwhelming. And I took an entire 2 semesters of color theory. That was part of our curriculum, in college. And my professor, who was unbelievable, Nance Gorin, if you're out there, I still love you. The things that I learned that I never could have imagined to learn about colors. I'm thinking, what, I got to learn what colors are in a rainbow? Like, what is there to learn about color theory? One of our projects, and I had a whole binder that I wish I could bring to you. I loaned it to somebody, and she never gave it back, and I don't know where she lives anymore.
That's me.
We're not going to go there. During our course, we made a binder where we had to do all of our assignments, and our final assignment was to make the cover. However we wanted to, but we had to tell why we use that color scheme. And I used a warm and a cool. I had a, you know, on either side, and then it said the name, and the name as it went across was the opposite. It was very cool. But one of the things that she made us do, and I think we all kind of forget that this is something that happens, is we had to pick one color, whatever that was, but we had to make it look like 2 different colors based on the colors that surrounded it. That is a challenge. Wow. It is hard. I don't remember what I picked, but I remember looking at the paper going, wow, I did it. Mm-hmm. That blue does not look the same over here. Colors change based on what's next to them. So don't dismiss it because somebody, you're talking to your friend Barb and she says, that would look really nice with teal. And you're thinking, no, it wouldn't. I don't know. Teal doesn't look like it would go here. And you grab it and you go, oh, it kind of does. It's not always obvious. It's not always the obvious choice. Try to work outside your comfort zone. Try to understand the color wheel a little bit better. Give yourself a little challenge in looking at things, but try to work a little outside of your comfort zone if you really, truly want to break out of the same thing you've been doing. Because we all do it. We all pick the colors we like, and we just keep doing them over and over and over again. I don't have that luxury because I have to show you guys how things go together, which is fine. But literally, if I made all these samples and I was just making them for fun, they would be probably blue, purple, and maybe a little bit of orange.
But you know, it's the same with quilting. You pick some of the ones that never in a million years you think would go with it, and then you put it out there, and it's like, wow, that's good.
What was that one you did that was, wasn't it like gold or orange?
No, it was orange. It was like...
Now, looking at the quilt and looking at the thread...
Yeah,
Barb, what are you crazy? And when you laid it out, it was beautiful. You never know. So don't convince yourself that it's not going to work and don't get yourself into this like, green is the only color that's going to go with that. It might not be. It might be something so outrageous that you surprise yourself. And sometimes you guys, we don't know when you're placing an order, if you're using stuff together or not. We don't know. You might be replenishing. You might be working on 5 projects at once. But sometimes we'll lay stuff out and I'm like...
I never.
Well, you know, is that going together? Or I never thought of putting that together. And then you'll post something. And I'm like, Damn, that's awesome. Yeah. Why did I never put, I mean, today, why have I never put the Hunter green with the hexagons? Because to me, I always see blue, and now I'm like, oh, okay. I didn't do that on purpose. But sometimes you don't know, and that's why, like, packing orders sometimes, we're like,
it's interesting.
Okay, I'm interested. Are all these going together? Are these different projects? And sometimes you blow our minds. And Margie, sweet Margie, who's still on Facebook, that woman can put prints together like you would not believe. And there have been times where I have looked at her and gone, are you insane? That's not going to go together. She'll pick this, she'll pick another print, and then she'll pull like a batik. And I'm like, that's a lot. I don't know. She puts it together and it's stunning. It's stunning. So join other groups and look at what they're doing. Look on Facebook, look at different things. There's so many, there's so much inspiration. And just because somebody else does it doesn't mean you can't, you know, use that as your inspiration. I'm not saying copy them, but hey, I've copied some of you guys. Judy Gordon, one of her questions when she had emailed me was, I picked this cork and this cork, but I want one more. Do you like this one? And I was like, ironically, somebody ordered those and I threw them on the table together. And I was like, oh, I just picked that out the other day. It's a great combination. So I get inspired by you guys, if you did not know that. So that is color theory. That is the best condensed version of color theory I can give you. We will be here next week.
Yes,
and
we will.
Then I will be taking 2 weeks off, but I'm sorry if it makes you sad, but I need to decompress and reprogram my brain and get ready so that we can do Facebook Live for a whole another year. It's been a year and a half. It's just been more than a year and a half.
Yeah.
Why are you guys still here? No, I'm just kidding. So it's good. But it's great. Thank you
Here's
to all of you.
Interesting combination.
Yes.
Patty says she loves the rainbow chevron with aqua dots.
Sorry. That sounds awesome. And two prints. One bold and full of color, one a little bit less bold and smaller. Well, look at the flourish with the aqua dots.
Yeah.
I did not buy those with that combination in mind. When I look at flourish and you want a contrast, the olive looks nice, the navy looks nice, because they contrast, because they're very opposite of this light colored print. If you want two fun prints together, the aqua dots look so cool with it. And we did not plan that, but it just happened to work. The day we were showing the cork off, we all grabbed a few, and I was like, look at aqua dots. Mm-hmm. So prints are fun, and we do have some prints that mix together. Yes.
I'm thinking Cindy is wondering if we're still going to be here for them to order.
Oh, yes.
We will be here.
I'm not going to be in front of you on Facebook for 2 weeks. We're not going anywhere. I'm just taking a video break. That's all. It's just a video break.
Orders
will be filled. And that's not going to change. If that ever is going to change, if for some reason we are all gone or we are closed, look at the top of the website. I always put it up there. I try to put it on Facebook, but I know not everybody looks and gets notifications. I put it at the top of the website that says, we will not be shipping orders on these dates. That is not changing for the end of the year. We don't have to worry about that until next year. There will be like a week next year where we won't be together, but don't worry about it. It has nothing to do with right now. I am taking a Facebook Live 2 week break. That's all. I will still be here. They will still be here.
Yep.
Yes. Okay. Don't get too scared.
We'll be here holding fort.
I will probably be here cutting oodles and oodles of cork. Because there are hundreds and hundreds of meters of cork on order right now. My back's going to hurt. It already hurts thinking about it. But it's okay. Because I love when our shelves are full.
Yeah.
Makes me happy. That is all, I think. Right? We good?
I think so.
We're good.
Yeah, we're good.
All right.
Okay, guys.
All right. We'll see you next week with a surprise.
Bye. See you next week.
Bye.
Bye, guys.